Hi, I'm Mike Massimino.
I'm Don Pettit, and this is the International Space Station Science Garage, premiere release.
Today, Don and I are going to speak with two of our friends, Chris Hadfield and Tom Marshburn, and they just got back to Earth. 3 days ago, they landed. And they're back here in Houston, and we're going to get a chance to talk to them about their adventures on the space station.
And stay tuned for future releases of Science Garage, where we will talk about all kinds of subjects dealing with human beings living and working in space.
So Chris and Tom, what did it feel like when the hatch closed in the bow, and you knew you were in your Soyuz getting ready to come home? What emotions, what did you feel like inside?
Well, there's a point of no return. There's the physical separation. We are done with ISS ops. And now it's all Soyuz. Reminds the commander.
Yeah.
And a little bit sad. Everybody says it's bittersweet, and it is when you do that.
Chris? I felt a surge of no way as well. Like, hey, we were just in the station. I just had a sandwich sort of, you know, like how can we possibly be floating out of the U.S. segment for the last time.
What's remarkable about it. It's not like you finish summer camp as a kid, say goodbye to all your friends, a big deal, your parents pick you up. This was, we continue ops, and suddenly we're gone. Yeah. We know it's going to happen, but the station program just continues on, and it just happens that we leave and somebody else arrives.
Yeah. Now, did you feel a difference between closing the hatch, realizing that, well, maybe something will happen, and we can open the hatch, and we'll be back in for a while, versus when the hooks opened and you felt your Soyuz physically depart from station? Did you have a different sensation?
Nah, for me, it was closing the hatch was like, suddenly an enormous chapter of our life has just gone, the clang of that thing shutting and like, that is a real sudden, and even though we knew it was coming for years and we knew specifically what time it was gonna be and it was all planned, and we said our goodbyes, we did a little video and stuck our sticker up, when that hatch closed,
that part
is over.
It's unceremonious. It says in the timeline, clang, and you're done. Whereas it's just a huge event in your life. But for me, back and away, the springs go boop, and they push you off, and you're just slowly moving out of your parking space on station. You're seeing
watching
it go away.
Watching the solar rays just drift by.
I really enjoyed the thought. We are now an independent vessel. We're just a little spacecraft that's now just going to start tumbling around.
The call sign Roman chose for us is Sailor, because he grew up going to Cuba and back. His dad's a hero of all Cuba. Mm-hmm. And so they have a big sailboat north of Moscow on the lakes there called Cuba. Mm-hmm. And so he grew up as a sailor. So he calls his crew Sail. So Parus 1, Parus 2, Parus 3. Yeah. And so suddenly we were three sailors again in our ship pulling away.
And I love that, because I also love hearkening back to the early days of spaceflight. You know, we were a little bit bigger than Gemini, but not much bigger, smaller than an Apollo. Yeah. And I love that idea of, this is spaceflight, doing the tiny vessels because it's so hard to get up into space and being crammed in there, everything you love about it.
No longer flying business class in the space shuttle.
Exactly. it's very much art and life overlapping in each other. If you watch 2001 A Space Odyssey with the big space station under construction, little vehicles coming and going, and some of them winged and some of them not, and it's sort of been the history of ISS as well, between shuttle and Soyuz and all the other things that are coming. Mm-hmm. And to be actually part of all that stuff happening is really nice that we spent all those years of doing rote memorization and muscle memory repetition in the Soyuz, because that's the only thing that really protects you. You come out of station after 5 months, you haven't been thinking Soyuz. You get in and you're like, holy cow, you could just be overwhelmed by it. Yep. But then you go, okay, we're in the Soyuz. Hey, I know the next 10 things that I need to do. Mm-hmm. And there's my seat, and I got to get my straw strapped, and I get this in the right place, and here's the display. And this is like old home week to me now. And it gets you back into
your training helps
the
you.
Right stuff to get yourself home.
The space you have to do it in is entirely different. You know, ISS, you know, guys know, you can bounce around the walls, you can fly 60 feet in one direction. In the Soyuz, you have a hard time just getting your wrist down to the strap to just tighten up.
True.